Welcome to BSc Statistics students. In this lesson, I explain a quartile deviation of normal distribution. So we have three important measures like quartile deviation, mean deviation, and standard deviation. In the measures of dispersion. Now I calculate quartile deviation. So what is meant by quartile deviation? The quartile deviation is going to be calculated by Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2 for any distribution. So we have to calculate first quartile and third quartile. Okay, so which means calculation of the quartiles. So since the normal distribution is of symmetrical distribution, based on the property of symmetrical distribution, we can easily identify and then calculate the quartiles. So now I explain everything through a particular normal distribution graph. We know it is a bell-shaped curve. It is going to be obtained, and if you consider the three particular quartiles we have, if you consider the limits of minus infinity to infinity, and then the median, that is second quartile. Actually, if you speak properly, the median, the second quartile, of course, it is also mu, x is equal to mu, which is also mean, median, and mode of the normal distribution. If you consider x is equal to mu, it is a median. This is the second quartile, which divides entire distribution into two equal parts. So that is the total area, if you consider for the normal distribution from minus infinity to plus infinity, if you consider like this, it is 1, the total probability. Are you able to follow this? This is what the total probability from minus infinity to infinity, the total probability, which means this area minus infinity to mu, this area is 1 by 2, and mu to infinity, this area, it is again 1 by 2, 0.5. 1 by 2 means this is 0.5, this is 0.5, the total area is, total probability is 1. Total probability, or we can specify integral, we can specify it is an area. So area or probability or an integral, we are all in the same sense, and it is equivalent to be 1, this is half, this is half, which x is equal to mu divides the distribution into two equal parts. Whereas if you consider the standard normal variate, the standard normal variate z value, which becomes 0 at x is equal to mu, z is equal to 0. From this, the areas of the normal distribution which are all going to be calculated with the help of this particular standard normal property, z is equal to 0. Now you see it is very clear that minus infinity to 0, this area, and 0 to infinity, this area, it is equivalent. Both are equal, because normal distribution, the value, the mean, it is divided into two particular equal parts at mean. Right? So here, the standard normal variate, if you consider, that is equal to 0. The mean of the standard normal variate is 0, and which divides entire distribution from minus infinity to infinity of normal distribution, which divides into two equal parts. And minus infinity to 0, we can easily observe that minus infinity to 0, this area, and 0 to infinity, this area, which are equal. That is, it divides into two equal parts, and its property, it satisfies the property of symmetry, right? And based on that, now you come to that, this is the second quartile. And while again, if you consider the first quartile, this would be the first quartile. For example, you consider x is equal to Q1, x is equal to Q1. And the third quartile, for example, you consider x is equal to Q3, third quartile here, and the which means 75% of the part it covers, and this covers only 25%, which means by the property of normal distribution, symmetrical property, the property of symmetry, since
this this is the quartile which divides this half part into again two particular equal parts. This is equal to this is equal. This is equal, this is equal. These two particular parts are equal. So for example, this is 0.25 and this is also 0.25. And this is also 0.25 because this is the third quartile divides this half of the part into two equal parts again, because it's a quartile which divides into two equal parts of this particular area. If you consider these two areas are equal, this is equal to this and this is equal to this. Therefore, these four parts are equal. This is 25%, this is 25%, this is 25%, this is 25%. So this is also 25%, 0.25, this area. And if you consider, therefore, I explain the area from minus infinity to Q3, the third quartile, it is 0.75. Here to here, that is this particular part, 0.25, 0.25, 0.25. So 75%, that is what exactly the definition of the 3n/4, the definition of third quartile. So therefore, this is what the part of the first part, that is the area of from minus infinity to Q1. Okay, and minus infinity to Q3, the area is 0.75. Minus infinity to Q1, the area is 0.25. So these two areas are equal, that is minus infinity to Q1 and Q3 to infinity. These two areas are equal. You please remember this entire picture in your mind, and so that start the calculation of the quartiles. Okay, from this figure, we can easily write probability of x less than Q1. That is also not only from this figure, but also from the definition of the first quartile, we can easily write that this is 0.25, the probability. That is what I am explaining, that it is an area, it is a probability, it is an integral, right? Okay, this is what the area, probability of x less than Q1. Up to Q1, this area, it is 0.25. From the definition of quartile, first quartile, or from this particular property of the area of the normal distribution also, you can specify this x less than, probability of x less than Q1 is equal to 0.25. Similarly, probability of x less than Q3 is equivalent to be 0.75, that is 75% of area. That is what I have specified here clearly. Minus infinity to Q3, the area is 0.75. From using these two particular results, that is use these two particular probabilities, now we have to calculate the values of Q1 and Q3. Only we have two particular sources, right? So now, for example, you consider what you have to remember. Two other particular points I specify here. The normal distribution, it is calculated, the areas of the normal distribution are calculated based on the value of Z, that is this Z. So whatever the area which was specified in terms of X, it is going to be converted in terms of Z. You remember, that is one of the basic point. What not only the quartile deviation or quartiles, but also for every probability, it is going to be converted from X to Z. That's very important, because all the areas of normal distribution were calculated for the different values of Z. So basically, based on the standard normal distribution which were calculated. So therefore, you have to convert everything in terms of Z. What I am considering, first of all, probability of consider X less than Q1, it is equivalent to be 0.25. So which means you consider this, this is nothing but probability of minus infinity less than X less than Q1. It is equivalent to be 0.25. You convert in terms of Z. Which implies, which means the standard normal variety is Z is equal to X minus mu by sigma. So therefore, you subtract with mu and divide with sigma for X, and so that you will convert in terms of Z. That is minus infinity minus mu divided by sigma. I am dividing for all the values. It is less than X minus mu divided by sigma. It is less than Q1 minus mu divided by sigma. Is it clear? It is 0.25. That's what I'm doing, just only the manipulating in terms of the in the inside of the probability. Okay, right? So this is nothing but probability of minus infinity minus mu by sigma. It is minus infinity. It is less than x minus mu by sigma. It is z. That is what required z value. It is less than q1 minus mu by sigma. Let you consider it is some particular value z1 is equivalent to 0.25. What is z1? Where z1 is equal to q1 minus mu divided by sigma. I identify this z1 in the figure. You come back. This is at x is equal to q1. Z is that the value is z1. Now you say this is why I am interpreting here. I am indicating here to identify the sign of z. Okay, so this is whether this is plus z1 or minus z1, we don't know. Now you see, you refer here, you can be easily identify. Minus infinity to 0, z values are minus infinity to 0 here. So therefore, in between this particular, all the values of z which are negative because minus infinity to 0. Here the z values are 0 to infinity, all the values of z are positive. Here all values of z are negative in the left hand side part, that is this particular part. That is what the very very important property, or we can say that is what the very very important identification of z, which leads the standard normal distribution has many number of properties, many number of theories which are developed based on the standard normal distribution, based on the normal distribution, because of the standard normal distribution. Hope you understand. So therefore, you see, the sign of the z1 is minus. Okay, I write clearly, it is minus z1. This is minus z1. If you consider this is minus z1. That is what this is the value of z1, that is sign of z1. Minus infinity to 0, all the values of z takes negative values, less than 0. Greater than 0, all the values here from 0 to infinity, all the values are positive. Minus infinity to 0, all the values are negative. This is a very simple indication. You can easily identify. Therefore, this z1 is minus. In this fashion, we have to identify clearly. That is another important particular point. That is, therefore, this is minus z1. Where minus z1 is equal to minus z1 is equal to q1 minus mu by sigma. But you know, you one more important point I specify. For different values of positive z1 only, positive values of z1 only, normal distribution table values are tabulated. That is, area's property of normal distribution was developed only for plus z1. You remember, for plus z1, all the areas of normal distribution, that is standard normal distribution only, based on the z only, we have calculated the area's property of normal distribution. And for different values of z only, we have calculated the areas, right? So therefore, now we have to, it cannot be identified from the tables of the normal distribution. So therefore, you have to convert in terms of the z1 plus z1. You see, again come back to the figure. This is minus z1. This area minus 0.25, that is plus 0.25, I'm sorry, 0.25, 25% of this particular area, because of the symmetrical property of normal distribution, whatever this minus z1, if you consider on the right hand side part and the same particular value, from minus infinity to 0, one negative value will be there. And from 0 to infinity, one positive value will be there. For example, this is minus 2, the plus 2 will be here. Am I right? Right. Because minus infinity to 0, whatever the area it is going to be considered, the same area is 0 to infinity because of the property of normal distribution, symmetrical property. So similarly, if we consider minus infinity to minus z1, how much area? The same area it is for z1 to infinity. For example, you consider z is equal to z1 here. plus z1. This is, you remember, this is a plus z1. This is plus z1 because it is a minus z1 from minus infinity in the area in between minus infinity to zero. It is one of the value, and zero to infinity, one such value of z1 will be positive. So what is the area here? From, because of, we know that why this is only z1, why not this, why not this? Because of the, this is 25% area, this is also 25% area, therefore this z1 is nothing but z is equal to plus z1. The same particular point at x is equal to q3, we get z is equal to z1. So because of the symmetrical property of normal distribution, this area and this area are equal, therefore these two areas are equal. This is 0.25, this is 0.25, this is 0.25, hence it is 0.75. Or else by subtracting one minus, you see, I am doing without figure, without considering figure, we can convert this minus probability of minus infinity less than z less than minus z1, not minus, yeah, minus z1 is equal to 1 minus 0.25. You subtract from 1 minus, you will, what you will get? Right, now 1 minus of this, it is nothing but probability of minus infinity less than z less than plus z1, it is equivalent to be 0.75. that is what I explained in the figure. Minus infinity to positive z1, that is positive value of z1, this area is 0.75. not only for q3, minus infinity to z1, this area is nothing but 0.75. hope you understand. This is what from the area's property of normal distribution, 1 minus probability of minus infinity less than z less than minus z1 is equal to probability of minus infinity less than z1 is equal to 0.75. Now I explain, we can calculate from the tables of the standard normal distribution, we can calculate this value of z1. So this is, area is given, we have to calculate value of z1. But actually normal distribution, areas of the normal distribution are calculated for different values of z1. It is just reverse. Like if the areas are given, area is given, that is 0.75, it is given, how to calculate the value of z1, that is also we can calculate. I show you what is the area's property of normal distribution, how to calculate the value of z1 from the area's property of normal distribution. Once you see, I show you the tables. You see, these are the tables here. So you see, hope you are able to, this is what the areas of the standard normal distribution. So from this, this is what the formula, psi of z is equal to 1 by root 2 pi integral minus infinity to z e power minus z square by 2 dz. This is what the formula of the areas property normal distribution. You see, it is very clear that minus infinity to plus z, for different values of plus z from 0 to infinity, we can calculate the value of z, that is the area's property of normal distribution. Now you see, z values are here, and these are also z values. So like for example, 0.40, this one, at 0.40 area, see, this is the area, at 0.41 this is 0.41, this is 0.42, this is 0.43, etc. These are the values of z, but it is required to calculate, these are the areas. Whatever all the values here, it is given the table, 0.5, 0.504, these are all areas. Now you have to calculate, you have to identify the area 0.75, you have to identify here, and you have to identify corresponding to the 0.75 area, what would be the z value, corresponding to the probability, that is area 0.75, what would be the value of z, you have to identify, that is, we have to calculate. You see here, where 0.75 is there, you please identify 0.72, 0.74, 0.74, 0.75.
0.7486, 0.7517, okay, which is nearest? 0.7486. This is near value, nearest value of 0.75. What is the value of Z? 0.6. This is 7. 0.67. This is what 7. You see, you observe here. This is what 0.7486. This is what the area, 0.75. Nearly 0.75. So the value of Z is 0.67. 0.67. Hope you understand. So corresponding to the 0.75 probability, the area is Z1 is equal to that, the Z1 value is corresponding to the area 0.75, Z1 value is 0.67, approximately we have considered the nearest value. So this is what the one particular value, but what is Z1? Minus Z1 is Q1 minus mu by sigma. So therefore Q1 minus mu by sigma is equal to minus Z1. Minus Z1 is minus 0.67. Do you understand? Because of Z1 is always positive. Remember that for all areas property of normal distribution, Z values are taken only positive values. For different values of positive value of Z, the area's property of normal distribution which are calculated, right? So therefore Q1 minus mu by sigma is equal to, that is, you see here Z1 is equal to 0.67 and Q1 minus mu by sigma is equal to minus Z1. So minus Z1 is equal to Q1 minus mu by sigma. Therefore Q1 minus mu by sigma is equal to Z1 is 0.67. So minus Z1 is equal to minus 0.67. So therefore you convert in terms of equation, therefore Q1 minus mu is equal to minus 0.67 sigma, which implies Q1 is equal to minus mu, I'm taking right hand side, the mu minus 0.67 sigma. Let you consider equation 1. Hope you understand. This is what the long explanation for the value to calculate Q1. Right now, I consider the second equation. You see, this one, first equation I have finished, and so that I have calculated one equation. And you consider second one. It is very easy. Probability of X less than Q3 is equal to 0.75. So therefore, you consider next one. Consider probability of X less than Q3 is equal to 0.75. Okay. Again, you convert in terms of Z. It is probability of minus infinity minus mu divided by sigma, and which is less than X minus mu divided by sigma, which is less than Q3 minus mu divided by sigma. I have considered one minus infinity, which implies probability of minus infinity less than X less than Q3 is equal to 0.75. So now you consider which implies. So probability of this X less than Q3 can be written as probability of minus infinity less than X less than Q3. It is 0.75. Lower limit is minus infinity. 0.75. Therefore, this is equivalent to 0.75. And therefore, from which implies probability of what is minus infinity? Minus mu by sigma. It is minus infinity. It is less than X minus mu by sigma. It is Z. Q3 minus mu by sigma. Let you consider it is some Z2. We have already considered Z1. Therefore, I have considered Z2. 0.75. Now you come back. This is what the area you will get from the standard normal distribution. You remember the probability of minus infinity less than Z less than some particular value of Z. This is only can be obtained from the tables. The area's property of normal distribution are calculated for different values of Z. Here plus Z. Whether it is plus Z or minus Z, we'll see and decide from the table, from the figure. So minus infinity, you see here X is equal to Q3, and this is what the some value of Z is equal to Z2, you consider. Now you see, you can easily identify that 0 to infinity, this value we have. So this is positive value. 0 to infinity, we have this X is equal to Q3 and Z is equal to Z2. At X is equal to X3, Z is equal to Z2. Therefore, this is the value in the 0 to infinity, therefore it is a positive value. So therefore,
and also the area minus infinity to Q3, the area is 0.75. It is also, we can identify that. Therefore, probability of minus infinity less than Z2 is equal to 0.75. The same thing it is. You see, if you observe this, probability of minus infinity less than Z1. Of course, here we have Z1 and here we have Z2. That's all. Here we have Z2. The area is 0.75. Both here also 0.75, here also area is 0.75. So according to the area 0.75, the value of Z, corresponding value of Z2 here, Z2 is also 0.67. That's all. So from the tables, if you search at the area 0.75, what would be the value of Z2 is nothing but from the tables, from the tables of standard normal distribution, Z2 is equal to 0.67. But what is Z2? Where Z2 is equal to Q3 minus mu by sigma, minus mu divided by sigma. Right. So therefore, Q3 minus mu by sigma is equal to plus Z2 is equal to 0.67. So I write in the next page, right? So because of the reason that Z1 we have calculated, now it is required to calculate Z2 also. Z2 also we have calculated 0.67. Therefore, Q3 minus mu divided by sigma is equal to Z2 is equal to 0.67. Therefore, Q3 minus mu is equal to 0.67 sigma. Therefore, Q3 is equal to mu. I am taking mu right hand side. Mu plus 0.67 sigma. Let you consider equation 2. What is equation 1? I write equation 1 here. Q1 is equal to mu minus 0.67 sigma. Let you consider equation 1. What you have to calculate? Quartile deviation. So, quartile deviation is nothing but Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. We have the Q1, Q3 values here. Substitute here. Q3 is mu plus 0.67 sigma minus Q1 is mu minus 0.67 sigma divided by 2. Is it right? So plus mu minus mu, we can cancel. And 0.67 sigma minus of minus plus 0.67 sigma. So twice 2 multiplied by 0.67 sigma divided by 2. 2 will get cancelled. Therefore, it is equivalent to be 0.67 sigma. What is that? Quartile deviation. So this is what I am writing as quartile deviation. This is 2 thirds. 0.67 is nothing but 2 thirds. 2 by 3 sigma. So therefore, quartile deviation of normal distribution is 2 by 3 sigma. It is approximately, we can consider as 2 by 3 sigma, 0.67. Right? So this is what the calculation of quartile deviation of normal distribution. Hope you understand. It is purely based on, completely based on symmetrical property of normal distribution and also the areas property of normal distribution. We have to deeply involve in the areas property of normal distribution while taking the areas, that is probability of normal distribution, and then you have to calculate, identify the value of Z1 and Z2. Both are same, of course. That is a Z1 which will be minus Z1 and Z2 will be plus Z2. So finally, quartile deviation is 2 by 3 sigma, 0.67 sigma we have obtained for the normal distribution. Thank you. Thank you so much.